Now the fallopian tube can be divided into three different parts. That is, one thing remember, fallopian tube is lined with ciliated columnar epithelia, and it also contains a smooth muscle cells. Yeah, smooth muscle fibers, we can say. You know, the movement of fallopian tube and this ciliary action, even uterine contraction also play a very important role. When this secondary site, when the ova comes from this ovary, comes into the fallopian tube and arrives to the ampullary isthmus junction for fertilization. It means these cilia, these muscles play a very important role in the movement of ova or ovum in the duct of fallopian tube. Now a fallopian tube can be divided. If you talk about their structure, fallopian tube has three different parts. What is that? It is infundibulum, it is ampulla, and the last one is called isthmus. So fallopian tube has three different parts. Fallopian tube has three different parts. One is it has three different parts. One is called initial part is called infundibulum. Infundibulum. The middle part is called, the large broad middle part is called ampulla. And the last one part is called, smaller structure is called isthmus, that joins the uterine cavity. If we talk about the structure of infundibulum, infundibulum starts with a finger-like process, and this is called fimbri. This is called fimbri. Infundibulum has a fimbri at their margin. At their margin, and what is fimbri? A finger-like projection. Fimbri lines with cilia also. It is also ciliated structure, and there is a central opening in between that fimbri. This is a part of ostium. This is called ostium. And remember, there is a larger fimbri like this, and there is the smaller structure, that is the part of ovary. In that diagram, it is clear that fimbri is not directly attached with the structure of ovary. There is a gap. There is a gap between the fimbri and the structure of ovary. Basically, this is the coelomic cavity. This is the part of coelomic cavity. And the ciliary action of fimbri, it generates a kind of suction pressure. That generate a kind of suction pressure that took this, once the ovum comes out of the ovary, that enters in fallopian tube by that fimbri movement of fimbri generate suction pressure, and that suck the ova or ovum inside the fallopian tube through this ostium only, remember. So the margin of infundibulum contains a finger-like projection called fimbri, and fimbri helps in the suction of ova that comes out from the ovary, first of all in coelomic cavity, and then they enters in fallopian tube. Clear? After infundibulum, there is a broad part, this one. This is the structure of, this is the longest part of fallopian tube, longest and broadest part also. That is called ampulla. And finally, If you talk about the, this is, suppose this is the part of infundibulum, this is the part of ampulla, and this is the part of isthmus that enters in uterine cavity. This isthmus, and that is the part of ampulla only. The ovum that released out from the ovary during during the menstrual cycle, here sperm appears, or we can say this junction, ampullary, what is that? This is the part of ova or secondary site, we can say, and this is a part of sperm. Mixing or union, we can say the union of ova and spermatozoa takes place at ampullary isthmus junction, or we can say the site of fertilization. What is fertilization? Simply, this is the mixing of union of attachment of ova with the sperm. So the site of fertilization is the ampullary isthmus junction. Remember that, very important part is here. What is the site of fertilization? The site of fertilization is this, and this is the structure called ampullary isthmus junction. What is that? It is called ampullary isthmus junction. Clear? So that is all about the fallopian tube. In roughly, what is the role of fallopian tube? Fallopian tube, except the ova, ovum or secondary site from the ovary after ovulation, and then it enters in the broad part of fallopian tube. Finally, it arrives to ampullary isthmus junction, where fertilization takes place. So it transports the ova, and it is the site of fertilization also, or we can say zygote formation takes place in the fallopian tube only. Clear? Now that zygote that is formed in the fallopian tube, it will goes to the process of development, and after initial development, few initial development, the embryo that is formed now enters in the uterine cavity for further development. So now we will see the structure of uterus.